Hello friends, so in the last video we introduced the concept of refraction of light. We studied what the phenomena is, what's the definition, what's the reason behind it. The phenomena is that light changes its direction when it travels from one medium to another, with the medium having different densities. And what's the reason? The reason is that speed of light changes when it enters another medium. We also did the laws of refraction, and one particular law was also called Snell's law. So now the Snell's law gave us the refractive index, because the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction comes out to be constant for a given color of light and for a given pair of media, and this constant is known as refractive index. So let's discuss more about this refractive index. So first of all, we know that in a particular medium, light travels in straight line. We also know that the speed of light is 3 into 10 raised power 8 meter per second. So this is the speed in vacuum. The speed that we often talk of is the speed of light in vacuum. In air, this value is only marginally less. So even in air, we consider the speed of light to be 3 into 10 raised power 8 meter per second, because there is not much difference between the two values. Though in air, since some particle, gas molecule are present, so they might pose some hindrance, but that too at a very, very low level. So the speed gets less only marginally, that the difference is insignificant. So even in a vacuum, this is the value, and even in air also we consider this value to be the same. But in glass or water, where the medium get more denser, the speed of light, it changes and it becomes lesser. So it travels fastest with this speed. This is the fastest speed of light, lesser. So in air, if there is just a very small insignificant difference, it could be 2.9998 or something. And in case of water or glass, in such kind of denser mediums, the speed gets less. So, suppose again we have a glass slab. So this is our air, medium 1. This is glass. This is medium 2. So, now as we say that the speed of light changes in different medium, so let V1 is the, let V1 be the velocity of light in medium 1, and let V2 be the velocity of light in medium 2. So now the concept of refractive index that we studied, so we say that refractive index is, we always study this to be of second medium with respect to first, because Snell's law, sine I upon sine R, is equal to refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. You can check the previous video. So here also mu of second with respect to one is obviously equal to sine I upon sine R, because I is angle of incidence and R is angle of refraction. This is definitely there. But there is one more formula, and that is V1 upon V2. That means refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium is equal to ratio of speed of light in first medium to speed of light in second medium. So always the medium from which light is coming, that velocity is taken in numerator, and the medium in which light is going, so the changed velocity, that is taken in the denominator. Sometimes this mu in some books, you can also find that they have used n symbol, so n to 1. The other way around, if you want to find the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to medium 2, then it would be inverse. Similarly, if you are using this convention, if you are talking about second medium, so the velocity in the numerator would be of first medium and vice versa. So this thing you have to remember, because often people confuse that if the formula says mu 2 1, so they often write this to be v2 upon v1, just by this that 2 comes first and 1 follows it. But no, it's refractive index of second with respect to first, but velocity of light of first upon velocity of light in the second medium. Further, here this is the formula when we have two different mediums and we don't know what are those mediums. The medium can be any, like air, water, glass. We can have refractive index between air and water. We can check the refractive index between the pair of media water and glass, or could be air and glass, and so on. And there are many materials. But the case if our medium 1, now medium 1 is what? From where the light is coming initially. If that medium is vacuum or air, because now since I told that the value of speed of light, there is not much difference between the value in case of vacuum or air. So we often consider this value same for both the cases, if we talk about vacuum or if we talk about air. So if our medium 1 is air, in that case refractive index of medium 2 is considered with respect to vacuum. So then we will not mention, suppose this is the case, and if medium 1 is vacuum, then refractive index of medium 2 is considered with respect to vacuum. So this is called absolute refractive index, and we denote it by N2 only. So need not to mention the other medium if the first medium is vacuum or air. Then we need not to mention. And why we don't worry that much? Because the absolute refractive index of air is absolute refractive index of air. Further, if C is the speed of light in air and V is the speed of light in medium, then the refractive index of this medium, medium M, then refractive index is NM only. And we need not to mention this second number, because this is fixed, that the second number is vacuum or air. So then this is C by V. So this C is always fixed. We all need to know is the value of V, and we can find that refractive index. So the main topic here is that we have related our refractive index with the velocity of light, with the speed of light in different medium. So refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is given by speed of light in medium 1 upon speed of light in medium 2, and vice versa. So you can use mu as the symbol for refractive index. In some books like NCERT, they follow N also as the symbol. Moreover, if we know that our medium 1, from where the light is coming initially, is fixed, and that is vacuum or air, in that case we say absolute refractive index. If medium one is fixed and that is your vacuum or air, then we use the concept of absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index. This absolute comes because our medium one, the value of speed of light in medium one is absolute, it's fixed, and that is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. It's not gonna change, it's never gonna change for vacuum or for air, because there is not much difference between the value in these two. So in that case, we will not mention this another second subscript. We only need to mention the first subscript, and that is always N2. Suppose here we are considering M as the symbol for our medium. So simply NM, because the first medium is fixed and that is our vacuum. So that always will be C by V. That means here this medium is second medium, because first medium is fixed and that is vacuum. And the formula is always speed of light in first medium. So speed of light in first medium means speed of light in air. So that's why C in the numerator and V in the denominator, where V is speed of light in that particular medium. So whenever we deal with some fixed values, we often come across absolute refractive index of different materials. So absolute refractive index of vacuum, with respect to vacuum, we would say, of all these with respect to vacuum. So if we say absolute refractive index of water, then its value is 1.33. Of ground glass, it's 1.52. So here, if we talk about air, absolute refractive index. So this is the ratio of speed of light in air with respect to vacuum. So our vacuum is the standard thing here, is the absolute thing here. And since you can see that this value for air is 1.003, that means we can take it to be 1. And that is the reason that we say that speed of light in vacuum or air is same. It's because of this reason that the speed of light doesn't change much when it enter in air from space, that our absolute refractive index for air comes out to be 1.0003. And since this absolute refractive index or refractive index is the ratio of similar quantities, it's velocity upon velocity. Here also, it's the speed upon speed. So it is a unitless quantity. So it doesn't have any units. It's simply a numerical value. Now here, if we say absolute refractive index of water, what does this mean? This means it is the ratio of speed of light in air, speed of light in air upon speed of light in water. This is what 1.33 means. Similarly, this absolute refractive index of ground glass equal to 1.52. This ratio is the ratio of speed of light in air upon speed of light in ground glass. And now don't confuse that I am considering here speed of light in air. You can also state the speed of light in vacuum, because the real thing, the absolute concept is vacuum, but the speed of light doesn't change much in air, because this ratio is almost 1. And we can get 1 only when this ratio comes out to be almost equal. So that means the speed of light in air and that in vacuum is not much different. That's why we have got this value to be 1.0003. So you can see that this value is almost equal to 1. So that's why we often use air instead of vacuum. So you can use vacuum or air interchangeably. But remember, whenever we talk of absolute refractive index, that means our first medium is vacuum or air. And the values that we obtain are unitless. And the value, suppose we have this for water, that means ratio of speed of light in air or vacuum to the speed of light in water. And moreover, those mediums which have larger refractive index, they are called optically denser medium. And those which have smaller refractive index, they are called optically rarer medium. Like you can see, the value of crown glass is 1.52 and that of water is 1.33. So crown glass has larger refractive index than water. So here, crown glass is optically denser medium and water is optically rarer medium, if we have to compare. But if we compare all these three, then air is optically rarer medium and crown glass is optically denser medium. So always this, whether the medium is optically denser or rarer, that simply depends on the value of refractive index. Larger the value of refractive index, more optically denser that medium is, and vice versa. That's all for today. Thank you.